Thomas here with Much Props, going to give you another how-to video. Today we are working on something from Overwatch. I'm not as familiar with the game as other people might be, but I do get a lot of requests to build stuff from it. So I thought I'd take a different approach to today's video. So I went on Etsy, and some of you know that all the things that I kind of build on the channel, a lot of them end up on my Etsy shop, and it's kind of how I fund what it is I do. Those sales are directly what keeps me making things. So I went on and was like, let's find some creative artist, somebody who's got some super awesome skills and maybe has just some raw cast that I could buy and then just finish off. I actually bought from this guy before. His name is PR Props. He's an awesome artist, does sculpts, then casts them and sells them for a very reasonable price. I'll definitely put his links down in the description below, so definitely go and check him out if you're looking for some resin casts of certain things. I've done a video of his work before. The skull controller that I did a while back was actually one of his sculpts, and I found some more on his thing that I kind of just had to have. So today we're going to work on the Anna Snow Owl mask, which you saw in the thumbnail. And we're going to paint it up, put some electronics in it, and add a little bit extra on the top of it. So, let's get to finishing off somebody else's work. Like I said in the beginning, I'm not very familiar with Overwatch, so I started by looking at a bunch of reference images of the character, and I noticed that she had some cool feathers that stick almost like ears out of the top of the mask. This cast didn't come with that, so I thought it'd be something easy to add to put on here. So I roughed out the shape on some poster board and then cut it out in some dents, 6mm and 4mm What the Foam from Cosplay Apprentice. It'll hold its shape and it won't need any extra supports. I glued my pieces together, then I trimmed off the edges to make them even. I placed it on the helmet and decided that the bottom needed a little bit of an angle so that the feathers would stand a little further up. So I took a stone bit on my Dremel and sanded a gradual angle on the bottom of both feather assemblies so that it would stick up a little more. I'm going to put some lenses in the eyes, so I need to cut this section out. I use a flush router bit in my rotary tool and carve out the eyes. Wear a respirator and have a vacuum handy. These shavings get everywhere. I carve a little inside of the edge, then once it's all cut out, I sneak up on the perimeter slowly. I also put in a drill bit and drilled out some holes for the EL wire and the strapping on the back.
Now that my modifications are done, I glue on my feathers with some super glue. There are recesses on the cast that help me to line everything up and put it in the proper position. I prepared all the surfaces with a light Scotch-Brite pad scrubbing and heat treated the EVA, then sprayed a base coat of black all-in-one spray paint. I start off my paint job with a base coat of some Armor Metallic Gold and Silver Plaid Effects paint and use two shades of the blue in the smooth satin line for a nice contrast. I know my paint scheme will deviate from the in-game model, but I wanted to make some of the details stand out a little more through the paint scheme. Took two coats of the paint to get an almost perfect coverage. I almost stopped here. I really liked how it looked without the weathering, but in Much Props fashion, it's time to dirty this thing up. So, using some black and brown Plaid Effects acrylic paint, I put it on straight, then come back in certain areas with a wet brush and loosen up areas so it's kind of uneven. Then I wiped it off with a paper towel. I did see it come up in one spot, so I switched to dabbing it to not be too rough with it. Originally, I wanted to use sunglasses, but I didn't have any handy that were big enough to cover the hole, so I used some of the Hobart's face shields that you see me use in a lot of my videos to cover it up. I use hot glue on it because super glue reacts with the material and actually clouds it up. To make sure it's got a good connection, I build up a wall of hot glue around the underside of the lenses. I bought a big variety pack of colored EL wires a while back, and I'm finding ways to try and incorporate them into my builds. Not being very comfortable with my electronic skills just yet, it's an easy way to take your prop to the next level. Some of my holes I drilled are a little difficult to get the wire through because of paint and glue and all that stuff, so eventually I got it to go through and it zigzagged across the whole mask. For the eyes, I wanted to make them glow as well, so I took another line of EL wire and rolled it into a little circle for the iris. Then I glued it down to some translucent foam to diffuse the light. I wrapped some areas with electrical tape to black out the gaps so that it didn't show through the back. Then I just hot glued them into place. I painted a pupil to block out the center too, and I used a splitter connector of EL wire that you can connect multiple lines with so that I only need one battery pack. Last thing to go on is the strapping. Just use some 3/4 inch wide elastic banding. Attaching it is pretty easy. Slip it through the pre-drilled slots and then super glue it into place on itself. I used some thin 2mm foam to reinforce the connection and lock it into place pretty much permanently. I also super glued a strap in the mouth area to hold the EL wire battery pack.
And we are finished. Here is the end result. PR props, I have to hand it to you. It is an awesome sculpt, super clean. Everything that I've got from him has a great finish on it, almost no cleanup at all. I did add some things to it, not that it needed it, but just to make some mods for myself. So the EL wire, I had to add some holes, and I just picked some random spots to put extra ones just because I really liked how the little sections right there were, and I was like, well, I gotta add more of them. So I added them in spots I know that aren't authentic to the game, but I think they're cool little additions that add an extra bit of pop. The eyes are kind of hard to see with the studio light, so I'll put a picture there. It is pretty visible without bright light shining on you. The inside of it is a little scary for me to put my face towards, but because my head's so big, it actually sits up here on the brim and down here, and it doesn't actually touch any of that stuff in there. If you were a smaller headed person, you'd probably need to think that out a little better than what I did in there with that monstrosity. But hats off to you, PR Profs. This is an awesome build. If you've got some money and you want to find somebody who does awesome resin casts, definitely give him a look. Maybe you'll try and do something like this and impress your friends with your painting abilities or your add-on abilities or your attempt at using some electronics, and they'll be jealous of your creation, or at least your paint job of somebody's creation. Yeah. Gotta support creativity. Maybe you'll get some.
Yay!
And inevitably, someone's gonna ask you, how'd you make that? You can give them one of these. Tell them, much props.